at lift points above the center of gravity, then it's stable all the time. When you lift points below the center of gravity, when the center of gravity is outside this lifting triangle, it's unstable. There's only little needed, like you see here, to make a tip. That's a bit hard to understand, but I'll show you that on the model. We can, though, also make a stable lift, like shown here, which is stable and will not tip over, but then the center of gravity should stay within this lifting triangle. Just by just increasing the length of the slings, you make it a stable lift. And make sure that the center of gravity is enclosed by the lifting slings. If I increase again the center of gravity, I'm definitely being unstable in this direction. See, it falls over, and if I take this, you see, there we go. You cannot lift it, it's unstable. In this direction, I'm still stable. Now, watch what I do now. I take two spreaders and make the slings spread. One here. One there. We can distinguish differences in lifting. First, horizontal movement. You lift it and you move it forward. It's horizontal movement. Move it from horizontal to vertical position, like this pressure vessel. It's horizontally and then it's erected into vertical position and placed on the foundation, usually with two cranes. Then you can lift loads above the center of gravity, so the lifting points above the center of gravity. And generally speaking, there's no problem with that. That's a straightforward lift, no sweat. But a lot of pieces are lifted with lifting points below the center of gravity, and you have to be very careful when you do that. You come into that issue later on. So those are the main things, and then of course you can lift it more than one crane. When you are somewhere in the middle of nowhere, for instance, you are somewhere in Baku, in Azerbaijan, and someone asks you, I need a crane to put a load on a ship, and you have no clue what cranes are available there. You have the yellow pages, you find some crane companies, but you have no clue what crane you need. How should I establish a rough idea of what crane is needed? Say, I take, for instance, let me put something else. I have a building in Azerbaijan, which looks like this. The building is here. Other buildings, you cannot stand there, but on the building, on the top, I need to put an air conditioning unit, which is 5 by 5 by 5 meters, and it weighs 10 tons. The building is standing, it's 20 meters high, and it's 20 meters wide. What crane do I need to put that air conditioning unit on the back of the building?